It's our second week of doing the news, and we are so excited to update you all about our school. We have some great segments for y'all to watch. Let's get started. What is up, SVdP Tigers? I'm here to give you your updates and announcements for the week. This week is Spirit Week, and here is a fun thing to do each day. Monday, jersey or t-shirt from any college. Tuesday is election day, wear either a red, white, or blue shirt and vote for a new Tiger mascot. On Wednesday is green and gold day, wear a green or gold shirt. Thursday is crazy sock day in the primary building, it's the 50s day. Friday is crazy hair day, and I hope you have a great week. SVdP Tigers, today I'm bringing you all the weekly sports updates and achievements. First up, we have the cheer squad, who have been working hard every day and trying to keep up the SVdP Tiger spirit. The cross-country season came to an end, but even through COVID, our runners managed to do amazing at their meets and worked hard every day. Just a friendly reminder to sign up for basketball or fitness and conditioning if you haven't already. They both start in November. That's all I have for you this week, but go Tigers!
Tigers, here's your weather for the week. Monday and Tuesday are going to be cool and sunny days. Don't forget to bring your sweatshirts. Wednesday and Thursday are going to be a little warmer with some clouds. Friday, it's going to be warm and sunny, and it's going to be a beautiful day. That's the weather on SVdP News. See you next week.
Hey y'all, I'm going to be giving you lunch for the week. On Monday, there's going to be steak fingers and fish sticks with veggies. On Tuesday, there's going to be some delicious beef and bean burritos and cheese quesadillas. On Wednesday, some tasty beef lasagna and hot dogs will be served. Thursday, there's going to be grilled cheeseburgers and nuggets with some cheesy mac and cheese. On Friday, of course, there's going to be pizza and spaghetti with meatballs. That's the lunch for the week.
Hey y'all, this week's highlight from our fine arts department is our middle school drumline. This is our middle school drumline playing the Tiger Cadence.
Drumline, two, up!
Hey Tigers, I'm back with another saint for this week. This week's saint is Saint Christina the Astonishing. We chose her to be this week's saint because today is All Souls Day, and her story has to do with All Souls. She was born to a poor family and became an orphan at a very young age. She was raised by her two older sisters, and when she was 21, she had a severe seizure and was thought to have died. During her funeral, she recovered and levitated to the ceiling of the church. They lowered her back down to the altar, and she woke up. She explained that she had been through both heaven and Hades. She then returned to Earth with her new mission, which was to pray for all the souls in purgatory. And that's the same thing we do today on All Souls Day. This week's special segment was a tour with Monsignor through our new Our Lady of Lourdes Chapel.
He told us about all the stained glass windows, the organ, and all the amazing things inside. Let's take a look. So I'm here with Monsignor, and I'm going to give y'all a little bit of the story of why we had this chapel. So one of our members of our SVdP community, Jane Abair, was diagnosed with cancer, and it was almost like deadly, and she spent the last couple months of her life spending time with her family and praying and just trying to make the best of what she had left. And so she went on a trip to Lourdes in France and went into the spring and was touched by the water. And when she came back for her doctor's appointment, she was miraculously healed. And all her cancer was practically gone. And there was no other way to explain it besides her going to Lourdes and going to the spring. Monsignor, would you like to elaborate on the story?
Well, the cancer returned, and she eventually died of cancer at 47 years old. That's why on this beautiful icon there are 47 roses in honor of her. And this beautiful icon that was done by a lady in California who did the same one that we did have, the same lady that did that is in the St. Vincent de Paul icon in the large church. So we dedicated the chapel to Our Lady of Lourdes in honor of Jane Abair.
Right now, we are in front of the chapel's new organ. It's a Mr. Roland organ, and it's very special. Now, Monsignor is going to tell you a little bit more about it.
It came from a church, Holy Trinity Church in Dallas, and Mr. Nance knew of the church in Dallas could no longer use this organ that was too small for the building new church. And we purchased that and had it installed, and it's a beautiful organ. It has a great sound on it. That's about as far as I can play on it. It has 1,800 pipes in it. 1,800 pipes. Some are just little tiny ones, and some are the big ones you can see right here in front. But it makes a beautiful sound.
So this is our beautiful stained glass window with Our Lady of Lourdes, who is what our chapel is named after. And Monsignor, can you tell us a little bit more about her?
In the 1850s, Mary appeared to Bernadette Subaru at the side of the Gave River in France. It's a beautiful shrine, and many miracles have happened there. And this particular window was made by a company in College Station, Foster Glass, and it's a beautiful depiction of Mary under the title of Our Lady of Lourdes.
We're now standing in front of the stained glass window. It's a beautiful picture of St. Bernadette, and Monsignor can tell you some more about her.
Bernadette came from a very poor family. She was not well educated, as school goes, but one day she was in the grotto by the Gave River, and Mary appeared to her, and through several different times of what are called apparitions, when Mary makes herself, we can see her in appearance, she gave Bernadette some messages about being holy, and Bernadette eventually went into a convent, and her body has not decayed. She's one of what we call an incorruptible, and her body is in a convent in Nevers, in France.
This is the Tree of Life stained glass window that used to be in our big church, and it is by the baptismal font because it represents the waters of life and the waters of baptism. Monsignor, do you want to tell us a little more about it?
This window was donated by a parishioner many years ago. When they remodeled the church in 2000, it ended up being put inside the church, and so most people didn't see it, but the red leaves are a symbol of the flame of the Holy Spirit. It was a depiction of a dove, the Holy Spirit, the water, the baptism of new life. And if you look at closely at the baptismal font, it has eight sides, because eight is the number of new life, the new day. And it's a beautiful window that now can be seen regularly.
And now to finish up our tour, we're outside in the prayer garden. It's still under construction, but it's going to be some lovely stations with the cross. Now, let's see here if you would like to talk about the stations with the cross before we finish up.
There's going to be seven stops on the way, and you walk one way, it's 1 through 7, the other way is 8 through 14. We'll have some flowers out here, some benches. Classes might come out here and have time just to meditate, do a Station to the Cross service, a class at a time. It's going to be a beautiful, wonderful place for us to come to prayer outside in God's beautiful creation.
And thank you again so much for giving us this tour today.
You're very welcome. Thank you for coming.
Thanks for watching. Have a great rest of your week, and we'll see you next time. Doodles!